Greetings, Scotty Reed here with a Black Talk Radio news report. This is a follow-up to the videos that I have been doing concerning the Carolina Panthers majority owner, Jerry Richardson, who settled four lawsuits related to workplace racism and or sexual harassment. So I did a video the other day. I was on my way to the airport and just reading some of the local news media and how it just seems that many of these players just do not get the seriousness of these charges, and they act like they are trying to be character witnesses for Jerry Richardson as he heads out the door. Now listen, I get it. This man was your former, or he's still currently your boss. He had a hand in drafting you to the NFL. He had a hand in making many of you millionaires. So I get it. I get it. You talk about how he treated you with respect and what have you. I get it. But at the same time, though, how is it that you don't get that perhaps your interactions with Jerry Richardson were not the same as these women and this African American scout? So when I'm working, I listen a lot to sports talk radio, and the local station here, the number one sports talk radio station here, is WFNZ. Again, that's WFNZ. And so I was listening to Chris Kroger today, and they had Captain Munnerlyn on. Now, this is one of the things that just shows that he just doesn't get it, or he is involved in just putting out BS to try to cover up for this man. And why, I don't know. I'm not saying you got to be disrespectful to the man. I'm not saying you got to say anything at all. But when you come on the radio and you say things like Captain Munnerlyn said today, is that, what did he say? He said that these are just allegations. These are not facts. Nobody knows what is he said, she said, and all that kind of garbage. Look, this man settled four lawsuits, three of them for sexual harassment. That's a pattern right there. That's a pattern. You just don't settle lawsuits without an investigation and without evidence coming up to make you settle the lawsuit. All right. Now, in terms of the African American, he settled a lawsuit with that person for calling them a racial slur. All right. These aren't allegations. These are facts, okay? If Jerry Richardson didn't call somebody a racial slur, I don't think Jerry Richardson would settle a lawsuit. So come off that BS, Captain Munnerlyn, because you are showing no self-respect as a black person. I believe you have a wife, you have a mother. I don't know if you got any sisters. You are not showing any respect for them when you defend this man and put things out there like, oh, these are just allegations. We don't know what's what. When, come on, common sense should tell you that if three people settled a lawsuit with him where there's smoke, there's fire. And then also let's throw in the fact, and I will keep pointing this out, is that Jerry Richardson has not denied the comments. When he issued his little farewell press release about him going to ride off into the sunset, he did not deny the allegations. He did not deny the report coming from Sports Illustrated that he settled three lawsuits for sexual harassment and one lawsuit for calling an African-American employee a racial slur. Again, the only thing that I want to know from the NFL's investigation, especially concerning the racial slur, is when did he make the racial slur? Was this before he gave that money to help bury and put up a memorial for the nine victims of the racist South Carolina terrorist Dylan Roof? Or did he call this man a racial slur after he donated that money? So Captain Munnerlyn, come off the BS. These are not allegations. This man hasn't denied anything. And if you got the guts, why don't you ask him? Why don't you ask him the next time you see him if these reports are true. Ask him why he settled these lawsuits if they were not true. All right, this is Scotty Reed with a Black Talk Radio News Report. Support independent black media. Make a donation today to the U.S.-based nonprofit Black Talk Media Project.